Let's set up Media Streamer on an Apple TV using DNS. To follow along with the video, you'll need a 4th generation Apple TV and an ExpressVPN subscription. The setup process has 3 main steps. First, you'll create a DDNS hostname. Second, you'll register your hostname with ExpressVPN. And third, you'll configure DNS on your Apple TV. To set up a DDNS hostname, you'll need to use a third-party service. For this tutorial, we'll use Dynu, a free DDNS service provider. Note that ExpressVPN is in no way affiliated with Dynu, and you are free to use whatever DDNS service provider you choose. To set up a Dynu account, visit dynu.com. At the top right corner of the screen, click Create Account. Fill in the necessary information before clicking Submit. A message will display saying Dynu will send you a verification email. Check your email and click on the link. You'll need to log into your Dynu account using the username and password you just created. Once you log in, click on DDNS Services on the left side. Then click Add in the top right corner. You have 2 options for the next step. Most users will want to select option 1, but advanced users familiar with setting up their own domain can select option 2. If you select option 1, simply create your desired hostname and enter it in the blank on the left. If you select option 2, enter your existing domain in the blank on the right. Now click Add. On the next screen, uncheck Wildcard Alias and enable IPv6 Address. Then click Save. Your Dynu account is now set up. Go to the ExpressVPN website. Click My Account in the top right corner. Then enter the email you used to set up your ExpressVPN account, as well as your ExpressVPN password. Click Sign In. On the next page, click DNS Settings on the top right corner. Scroll down to a section titled Dynamic DNS Registration. Enter the host name you just created with your Dynu account. If you used option 1 when setting up DDNS with Dynu, the host name will follow the format hostname.dynu.com. If you used option 2, simply enter the domain you used. Click Save Host Name. The word updated will flash on screen to let you know the host name was saved. Return to the page under the My Subscriptions tab. Then click Set Up ExpressVPN. On the next page, scroll down and select Apple TV on the left side of the screen. A DNS server IP address will appear on the right side of the screen. Make a note of it, as you'll soon be entering it on your Apple TV. Now it's time to turn on your Apple TV. Select Settings from the home screen. Then select Network. Depending on how your Apple TV is connected to the internet, you should see either Wi-Fi or Ethernet under the connection. Click whichever one appears. Then go down to Configure DNS. Select Manual. Apple TV will display your current DNS address. You should write this down in case you ever want to discontinue use of Media Streamer on your Apple TV and return it to its original state. Now it's time to enter the 12-digit DNS server IP address you found on the ExpressVPN page. Once you've entered it, click Done. You're almost done. You just need to restart your Apple TV. To do so, return to the Settings menu and select System. Then at the bottom, select Restart. Congratulations! You've set up Media Streamer on your Apple TV using DNS. However, remember that DNS is not a VPN and does not offer the same privacy protection. If you want to get VPN protection on your Apple TV, consider connecting it to the internet through a router running the ExpressVPN app for routers.